שברי מרנן ברוך אתה אדוני אלוהינו מלך העולם בורא פרי הגפן ברוך אתה אדוני אלוהינו מלך העולם שהכל ברא לכבודו ברוך אתה אדוני אלוהינו מלך העולם יוצר האדם ברוך אתה אדוני אלוהינו מלך העולם אשר יצר את האדם בצלמו בצלם דמות תבניתו והתקין לו ממנו בניין עד עד ברוך אתה אדוני יוצר האדם סוס תסיס ותגל הכרה וקיבוץ בניה לתוכה בשמחה ברוך אתה אדוני משמח ציון בבניה שמח תשמח רעים אהובים ישמחך יצירך בגן עדן מקדם ברוך אתה אדוני משמח חתן וכלה ברוך אתה אדוני אלוהינו מלך העולם אשר ברא ששון ושמחה חתן וכלה גילה רינה ותיצה וחדווה אהבה ואחווה שלום ורעות מהרה אדוני אלוהינו ישמע בערי יהודה ובחוצות ירושלים כל ששון וכל שמחה כל חתן וכל כלה כל מצלות חתנים לחופת המונערים עם משתה נגינתם ברוך אתה אדוני משמח אחד אני מקלה ומצליח
Sarah and Dan, I just want to say a few words. Sarah, Dan, parents, family and friends. I would like to just say to take a few moments to say a few words and to give you some insight about the ceremony that we just had in which Sarah and Dan were wed. The word in Hebrew for a man is ish. The word for Hebrew for a woman is isha. Those two words contain three letters each. In the case of ish, it's aleph, yud, and shin. In the case of the isha, the woman, it's aleph, shin, and hey. As you can see, those two words contain three letters, two of them which are identical, aleph and shin.
But in the case of Ish, there is Yud in the middle. In the case of the Isha, there is Hey at the end. Yud and Hey represent the name of God. The Torah and the Chachamim are telling us that whenever a husband and wife live harmoniously with respect and love towards each other, they bring the presence of Yah, of Hashem, into their home and into their dwellings. We all know that the first chuppah took place in the Garden of Eden, almost like here, in Gan Eden, in the paradise. The first chuppah where Adam, the first human being, approached God and asked him for a partner, for the woman, because he felt that he may not be able to fulfill his mission in this world without a partner, without a woman in his side. We know what happened, that God has put Adam to sleep and took one of his ribs and made Chava and made Eve. The rabbis are telling us that Adam and Eve, the first bridal couple, were so connected to each other and were so connected to God, so much so that when they were looking at each other, they only saw one other glow, the glow of each other's soul. The depth of their relationship was so much so that any husband and wife has the potential of having an everlasting relationship and a good marriage. Always the partnership can be good if it is based on the wisdom of our Torah and our Chachamim. In addition, in the Sheva Brachot that we just recited, the sixth Sheva Bracha says, Sameach tesamach ra'im ha'uvim. Sameach tesamach, please make happy. Please rejoice this bride and this groom in these days. Kesamechacha yetzircha began Eden mikedem. The same way that you have made happy Adam and Eve, the first bridal couple. What is this simcha? What is this happiness that existed? And the rabbis are answering that the simcha that existed in Gan Eden was that Adam and Eve, the first bridal couple, had everything they wanted. Everything they desired, they had. After all, they lived in the paradise, in the Garden of Eden. This is the blessing that we give the Chatan and Kala, the fact that you have the potential of having everything, of having Gan Eden, of having paradise. But please remember that we have to thank Hashem, we have to thank God for everything we have. Sarah and Dan, in the short time that I've known you, in the meeting, that first few meetings that we had, I have been very impressed with your commitment, with your warmth, with your sincerity, and especially with the love that you have to each other. I was very, very impressed, particularly about you wanting to have this chuppah according to the halakha, according to the Jewish law, to our strict tradition and heritage. I was very impressed with that. I'm confident that with your strong love to each other and with the strong family values that you both bring from the Mashal and from the Zaguri family, you will have a good marriage, committed marriage, loving and caring towards each other all the time. May God bless you with happiness, with prosperity, with all the things that you may wish. And may God bless you with the simcha that He blessed Adam and Eve, the first bridal couple. May He give you all the happiness you may wish. And may Hashem give you the zechut to build a Bayit Ne'eman b'Israel, everlasting house in Israel. We are now concluding the ceremony by having Dan breaking the glass, which signify that our happiness is not complete until the rebuilding of the Beit HaMikdash, the third temple. Dan, please repeat after me. Im eshkachech Yerushalayim, tishkach yemini, tidbak leshoni lechikim, tidbak leshoni lechikim, im lo ezkerechi, im lo aale, et Yerushalayim, על ראש שמחתי.